was here when we did Panchadashi 15th chapter? Over? Oh, okay. Yeah. You were there. Vaguely. You remember. Oh, you were there. Okay. Pardon me? Yeah, yeah. It is all a long time ago. That shows how long you have all been studying. That's wonderful. So, yeah, there we touched upon this briefly. This meaning what? Gunas. So now, Gita also we have touched. But this we thoroughly did because that whole chapter was on Shanta Vritti, Ghora Vritti, and then Mudha Vritti. Vritti means thought frame, state of mind. State of mind. So Shanta Vritti, that we don't even need to translate, right? Shanta means what? Peaceful, happy. And then Ghora Vritti. I already told you what Ghora meant in the last class.
Terrifying,
horrible. And then finally Mudha Vritti. Mudha also we know by now. Even if we don't know anything about the word Mudha, we know we don't want to be that. Mudha means what?
Fool.
Yeah. Deluded. Yeah. Murkha, fool. Mudha, deluded. Yeah. Murkha, fool. You know, that's why in the Bhajagovindam, you know, in that one, Bhajagovindam, Mudhamate. Hey, Mudhamate. You know, and it's usually translated as, oh, fool. It's not fool. Oh, you deluded one. So, Mudhavritti is deluded state of mind. So, this is Panchadashi. And the same thing is there in the Bhagavad Gita on the topic of the gunas. Okay? So we'll start with a prayer to make it go nicely.
Om Sahanavatu, Sahanavunatu, Sahaviryam Karavavahai, Tejasvinavadhitamastu mavidvishavahai. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Maya, never had the first word Maya in any class. So Maya, whose time has come now, that Maya, you know, see what she does. Maya, you know, is the Kalpita Shakti. Kalpita Shakti means an imaginary power. Imaginary doesn't mean a made-up Shakti. Made-up only from the standpoint of the Paramarthata, from the standpoint of the Paramarthika Satta, from the standpoint of the ultimate reality. Everything is made up, right? What to talk of Maya? Everything is made up. So Maya becomes the first imaginary Shakti, so to speak. The first thing that you know, that is dependent upon Brahman, that separates as it were itself, herself from Brahman in order to create. That is, you know, this is also a Kalpita, what's its name? Kalpita means a made up trajectory for the people who say, where did this body come from? Why was I born? When was my first birth as a jiva? Well, jiva is anadi. Why is it anadi? If it is anadi, is it also ananta? Ananta means no end. Anadi means no beginning. If it is no beginning, will also it be no end? No, there is an end. How do you know? What about karma? So if I do action, will I have result of action? Yes. So what should I do in order to get rid of the results of action? Considering that I can't sit without acting. So these are all questions that are asked from the standpoint of the body-mind-sense complex. So the one endowed with a body and hopefully a mind is asking these questions. Who am I, etc., etc. From the standpoint of the ultimate reality, these questions are moot. There is no point in asking these questions because there is no difference at all. Everything all is one, one is all, everything is just one. And there is no action, there is no action to defend, there is no result of action to exhaust. There is no rebirth, there is no birth, let alone rebirth. And there is no bandha, no bondage, and so therefore there is no
moksha.
There is no moksha, with no, you know, na bandho na moksha. Iti esha paramarthata. This is what paramarthata is. No guru, no shishya. Oh, no guru, no shishya, yippee. Yes. No jnanam. Because no ajnanam, nothing. This is what is called paramarthata. Paramarthata means that which is all, where everything is just one. But that is not the case, right? That's not the case because we are dealing with a manifest jagat. Yeah. Which we wish it would be manifest, especially when one is in hot water, one wants the jagat to just dissolve and resolve. Oh Pralaya, where are you? We think. You know, when you read the news and it's just so boring and so difficult to understand. Wow, where is this world going? So many killings, so many things. And then you suddenly remember Pralaya. Pralaya is that which makes everything all one again, which gets rid of the jagat in a hurry. So you can say, oh Pralaya, ajao, come, you know. But really speaking, barring those moments, one has to deal with the world. And what constitutes the world, even before other people, and forget other people and annoying, bugging things and bugging people, is your own body. If you have a body, you have problems. See, nobody is disagreeing. Yeah, because that is the truth. That is the truth. Yeah. So even in a classroom, everybody has their favorite spot. And somebody else takes means the class doesn't go well for them that day. Yeah. You know, why do you have that favorite spot? No, because I have a sore spot here. That's why that is my favorite spot. So that the sore spot is not activated during the class. That's why I have picked this spot. You know, spot on. And then what, you know? Then somebody else needs a pillow. But on the day that pillow has been earmarked and initialed, somebody else has taken it. Yeah. Well, because we had an out-of-town visitor, they didn't know all these things. You know, and they didn't have fear for their life. So they took the pillow. So, like this you have to deal. Jagat doesn't mean don't look over there. Oh, that horrible jagat bothering me. All you need for jagat is, jagat starts right here. With your own body, with your own mind, with your own senses. Atra eva jagataha upalabdhihi. So the jagat is available wherever there are complaints available. And that starts with the body and continues with the mind and gets amplified with the senses and so on and so on. Really, that's all there is. This jagat means, you know, starts with your body. So, as soon as one is endowed with the body, the problem starts. You know, think about the first minute of birth. What does the baby do?
Cries.
Yeah. It tries to breathe, it cries, it coughs up, and you know, it's just like, oh my God, you know, maybe it was enjoying some Gandharva music in heaven, you know, maybe it was some kind of a wonderful Carnatic music concert, Gandharva music, and then suddenly the punya stopped, that's why. Punya trickled down and stopped, and suddenly the desire for something, we don't know what yet because the baby is tiny, something made it take on a body in this particular family, in this particular pecking order. That's all karma. Yeah. And then it cries, it bellows, strengthening the lungs as it were. And that's enough. The body means you are already endowed with the jagat. You don't need anything.